Spoke with the team in the locker room. AJ, what can you tell us?
Well, Adam, the team blaming things in all phases of the game as the reason they lost to the Ravens today. But like you mentioned, Lamar Jackson, arguably the biggest problem. 116 yards on the ground and a rushing touchdown. This dude can run, and it's no secret. Seattle knew it, too. In fact, they told me they really liked how they game planned for the designed runs that the Ravens like to call for Jackson. But it's his things that he can do that you can't game plan for. Extending the play, scrambling when everything falls apart that the Hawks just couldn't overcome today.
Yeah, the whole game, I'm telling him, we can't rush how he want, can't get out of rush lane because we're scared he's going to run with the ball like he did today. Even though we stayed in our rush lane, he still fine. Any little crease and made a play and got through that. So he made a lot of guys miss today. He had a good game.
Lamar Jackson's fast. It's like, nah, but you know, we just got to execute our plays, man, get off the field. We got to get some turnovers. You know, we got to hit the offense out.
It makes it really tough because, you know, you come up on him and then he throws it over your head, and if you stay back, he takes off. So it really makes you be very disciplined. And, you know, he did a good job calling his number today.
The most exciting thing for the Hawks defense is that they only have to face Lamar Jackson once this season. And next they go to Atlanta, face a much more traditional pocket passer in Matt Ryan. Also, Earl Thomas making his return to CenturyLink Field today. He got a very warm welcome from the 12s, I can tell you, Adam. And he and Russell Wilson exchanged jerseys after the game. Nothing but respect for Earl Thomas and the players that he used to call his teammates. Live from Seattle, I'll send it back to you.